all the troubles my sorrow my fears. I'm living moment, every moment.
People pay for what they do, and still more for what they allow themselves to become. And they pay for it simply by the lives they lead. James Baldwin. The day I was born started off bad and only got worse. I guess it was lucky I got born at all.
I will walk on the streets of that city of gold. I will bask in that heavenly light.
Hey, Earl, about pass me another one of them blue ribbons, will you?
Oh, you had enough already, Travis. The sun's barely been up an hour. My love keeps records.
Jeez, Ruth, did you quit that? We got another damn 20 miles before we get to the airport, and you're starting already?
Well, your driving will be lucky if we get there at all.
Poor job, too. Just cool it and shut up, because you're going to wake the baby up.
Yeah, which one?
My little sister, that's the one. Smart ass.
Through the mercy of God's loving grace, someday He will call me to the marvelous place.
What did you do with my damn cigarettes? Hey, Earl, you got any more smokes?
No, I don't. You want to know why?
Why?
You smoke it all, that's why.
When Travis smashed into the pickup, the Chevy folded up like an old accordion. It's a wonder they all weren't killed. The drinking must have helped.
He's a liar. It's his fault.
Truck was just there.
Mama didn't know what hit her, even though she went through the windshield. She slept through the whole thing. Lucky that way. Mama, Ruth Ann. I got the nickname Bone from Uncle Earl, who took one look at me and said, she ain't no bigger than a knuckle bone.
A-N-N-E.
No, A-N-A-N-N. Neither Aunt Ruth nor Granny could write very clearly, and they hadn't bothered to discuss how Ann would be spelled. So it wound up three different ways on the form. And as for the name of the father, Granny refused to speak it after she'd run him out of town from messing with her daughter. Aunt Ruth had never been sure of his last name anyway. Oh, they tried to get away with just scribbling something down. But if the hospital didn't mind how a baby's middle name was spelled, they were definite about having a father's last name. So Granny gave one, Ruth gave another, the clerk got mad. And there I was. Certified a bastard by the state of South Carolina.
Ruth Ann's all right, but Maddie Raylene would have been better. Of course, nobody bothered to ask me.
Nobody bothered to ask you. Nobody bothered to ask me. It's my baby.
That's your own damn fault for sleeping three whole days.
I had a concussion, Mama.
How many babies I had, and did I sleep through any of them? I don't think so.
What's that mangy dog doing in the yard? You ought to get Earl to shoot that dog, Mama. It's probably got rabies or something.
Listen, kid, you ain't the first boat rat to go through a windshield.
None of this would have happened if I'd have been awake. They don't ask you for a marriage license before they put you on the table. I'd have said I was married and they would have believed me. The way I'd have said it. No questions, no lies.
No lies? You ain't married.
Well, it's only when you bring it to their attention that they write it down.
You know anybody reads them courthouse records? Anybody come on my porch asked to see my birth certificate would get chased right on out of here. Might even take a shot at them.
Well, it matters to me.
Why? You want something on your wall to prove you done it right? Child's proof enough. And no stamp on her nobody can see.
I don't care what they say, Bone. I won't have anybody call you trash. That stamp on your birth certificate is the one they already got for me. Yeah, no good. Lazy, shiftless. I work my ass off over other people's peanuts and they look at me like I'm a rock on the ground. No matter how hard I try, I still can't get away from it. One soft-talking, black-eyed man fixed that. He set a mark on me. And set a mark on you. Don't you worry, Bone. You got me now. And I got you. And we'll stick together, the two of us.
Hey, hey, how's my little sweetie pie?
Sweet as ever.
You watch yourself. That's my sister you're talking about.
Come on. I just don't understand why don't y'all let me just go up there with you. You know, I could pretend like I'm her daddy.
In the courthouse?
Yeah.
Come on, Earl, with all the deputies and sheriffs hanging around.
Fresh out of the county farm for shooting up your own brother-in-law, Chevy, you think they won't know who you are? You got kids running around Greenville County, all right, but Bone ain't one of them.
Okay. All right. Here we go. We're going over there, Mama.
Here we go, Bone. You put on a good show for Mama.
Okay.
Let me see if I heard you correctly. You said you want this fixed?
That's right. I was there, you see, and really it was my fault. I couldn't find her husband. And there was so much excitement, I just got confused. Just very confused. What with Vanny here all bloodied, looking like she was dead to the world. You know how these things can happen.
Oh, I do. I certainly do.
You shouldn't have swung at him, Ruth. Didn't help.
A man, Bone.
A real man. He's handsome and kind. Hardworking. He's gonna take care of us girls. I know we will. So you wish me luck, sweetie.
Okay, good luck.
Well?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Oh. Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks, Mama!
Sickness and in health, till death do you part?
I do.
And do you, Annie, Take this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part.
I keep my eyes wide open.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
For the tie that's fine, because you're mine, I walk the line.
Bone, who's your new daddy?
You are.
Yeah. And who's the best daddy in the world?
You
are. You got that right. Come on. Come on. You want to go again? Ready? All right. Here goes. Woo! Oh, yeah. You're flying. Honey girl. Sweet thing. Take a picture of me and Bone.
Night is dark and day is light.
Bone and her daddy. He's going to be a new daddy real soon. Woo! There we go. Woo!
Proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
We're sorry about that, Lyle.
You're running late.
You tell me.
Through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and loving kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of Jehovah forever. Amen.
My Lyle worked two damn jobs for you, Annie Boatwright. He wouldn't have died in the road like that if it hadn't been for you.
How dare you?
I'm trying to keep you people up.
You hold your tongue, woman. God's got his eye on you.
You got no right to judge us. No right at all. Nothing else will ever hit you this hard. Now you look like a boat rat. Now you've got the look. You're as old as you're ever gonna get, girl. This is the way you'll look till the day you die.
I'll tell you what. It wouldn't be nothing for me to go over there and teach them people a little something about manners and respect.
Earl, you can't solve everything with a shotgun, my lord.
Oh, I was thinking more along the lines of a 2x4.
Settle yourself, Earl. Nobody's going over there, and that's that.
And since when you start telling me what I can and can't do, huh, Ray?
Daniel, stay here with Mama as long as she needs to. We just take care of our own, like we always have.
Our daddy. Practically every day, we go on a picnic. He throw me all over the field.
That ain't your daddy, Bone.
Yeah, you're out of town.
Uncle Earl nearly killed him.
Listen up, Garvey. I'm gonna tell you something I've been keeping from you, because all the grumps don't want you to know about it. On account of my scare you.